So, I'm going to begin by refuting some of the second advocate's claims against some of my, the just situations at hand. One thing she mentions is the fact that service for HIV and AIDS testing will only be provided if there's legalization. Well, currently, we have services that provide these sorts of needs and help without legalization and absolutely free. Examples of these include the Health and Service Executive and the SAGE project, which are both government-run through the Health and Service Committee to address needs of HIV testing, hepatitis A, B, and C testing, vaccinations, smears, counseling, contraception, pregnancy testing, and advocate support, referral, and education. Next, I'm going to make a comment that she made, or make comment about the point she made about rape and trafficking. The fact of the matter is that rape does not decrease under legalized prostitution. In fact, it increases. This was found to be in Nevada. Rape in legalized brothels increased by 90% when it was legalized. And the reason for this, according to the Coalition Against Trafficking in Women, is because prostitution cannot eliminate rape when it is in itself bought rape. The connection between rape and prostitution is that women are turned into objects of men's sexual use. They can either be bought or stolen, and a culture in which women can be bought for use is one in which rape flourishes. Now, for trafficking, I'd like to make the comment that it actually has increased in other countries, such as Australia. There was an increase of 350% in Australia when it was legalized, and a lot of the traffic was underground as opposed to in the legal brothels because, of course, they don't want to be found out, but many of the legal brothels, 75% of them, in fact, have have people involved who are not licensed. So that means they were actually trafficked in, but they're actually working at those legal brothels. And then I'd like to comment about the fact that prostitution is not a crime. Okay, yeah. Prostitution is a crime. It's a public order crime. Public order crimes are the same things as DUIs and drug offenses, in which individuals are arrested for the fact that they are doing something that the public does not see fit and does not want around them. And she makes a comment about my life houses and saying that they don't work and they're sort of like rehab for prostitutes and then just go in and out of them. Well, the fact of the matter is, life houses are a new innovation. And according to Melissa Garley, she makes the note, it's definitely the wave of the future where women are offered services instead of arrest. We're trying to help these women in a way that will benefit them. So yeah, not everyone's using it now, but we're setting a precedent so that they can be helped in the future and there won't be this arresting of the prostitutes. And that's all I have to say. Thank you very much.